We are here with another great tip for your Dynamo plugin for your Revit project. And this is the way that we can export and import our data to Excel and bring it back and write it to our parameters in our Revit project. Let's go. This is javadhamidi, the co-founder of TATBIM-English channel. We upload weekly tutorials about Revit, Dynamo, and other kind of BIM software. So if you're new, consider subscribing and ask your questions in the comment section. And if you want to access to our exercise files and some premium tutorials, you can go to our Patreon page. The links are in the description. Don't miss it. Okay, as I said, using the data in BIM process is the thing that you need to do to differentiate your process with other processes like CAD. If you wouldn't do that, it's just a 3D model and it's not BIM, and you haven't done the I part of the BIM in your processes. And the best and one of the best software to process our data and work with our data is Excel or Microsoft Excel, and make a link and a strong link between a Revit and Excel is a little bit hard. But Dynamo open lots of potential in this area, and you can import and export data easily to Excel and bring it back and write it to your element parameters. Let's go to the screen share and let me show you how this process works. Okay guys, in this model we are going to do an example to show you the process to how to import and export Excel Revit data to Excel and how to integrate these two great software together and improve your and enhance your workflows. Okay, we have this sample project here. We are going to export the room data to our Excel sheets, and then we are going to assign the departments there because it is easier, and then we are going to import them back to the Revit and set them to the department parameter of our rooms. Okay, let's open the Dynamo here. Let me open and create a new one. The first step is to extract the data from the Revit. So we are going to go and select all of the categories, all of the room elements in the project. Let me search the category node here, and then let me set it to room. We want all of the rooms here, and then we need to select all elements of a category. Okay, it is great. We have the elements here. As you can see, we have 14 spaces here, and it is great. I want some values and parameters from these elements. Let's see the rooms here. Let me select one of the rooms here. I want the number and the name parameter, and also I want the department parameter too. It's gonna be empty, but I need the column in our Excel sheet. So we want the number, name, and department parameter in our Excel sheet. You can export as many as you want, so there is no limitation in that area. Okay, let me create a code block here. Okay, that's great. I have these two here, and also we want to get the get parameter value by name. Okay, let me connect these elements to this, and we want the parameters to. Let me create three copies of this node here, and
Let me connect these three to each of them. Here we have the department. It is empty. We know it. It's the name. These are the names, and these are the numbers. Okay, that's great. We have the data here. Let's go and export this data to our Excel sheet. You need to go to the import and export, and then in here, go to the data, and here, click the export Excel note here. Okay, we need a file path, so search for file path note first. And then click on here and browse the place. I'm going to save it on my desktop. And the file name is gonna be xData or export date. That's great. Let me connect this to this. Also, as you can, let me open an Excel file here. You know, we have some sheets in Excel. Let me open Excel. Things here, we have some sheets here. We can have some multiple sheets in one file. You need to specify the name of this sheet too. Let me put it on rooms. Okay, that's great. Then connect this to this. And another thing that I need to show you in Excel file is about the rows. As you can see, we have a start row and we have a start column. In Excel, it is true that it is 1 and 1, but for Dynamo, it is 0 and 0. So if you want to write your data from here, you need to, for example, import the 0, 1 and 0, 1. 1 and 1 for the start row and for the start column. So it is necessary for that. But let me put a number for that. 0 or maybe 1 and 1 would be better. Let me put it here. And also we want the data too. Okay, we have the data here, but we need to let me bring them here. We have the data, but they are separated. Let's create a list from them. Search for list create, and then add three items here and add all of them to here. Okay. It is great. As you can see, we have this. Let's write them as like this, and I'm going to explain for you one tip here. Let me connect this to data and run it, and you will see the Excel file here. As you can see, it's not the thing that we want. We need to transpose this list. To do that, you need to let me disconnect this one. You have a node which called transpose. It will swap the columns with rows, and it will be the thing that we want for our date. Let me delete this one. These are the last ones. We need to delete them. As you can see, we have the name, we have the numbers, and for the department, it is empty, so there is no problem. But let's, for example, let's create some department for that. For example, storage. I'm going to create some random ones. It is not a really relative ones. Maybe residential. And then, for example, office. I'm just assigning. As I said, there is no relevance between these dates. Okay. We have this data, but one tip here, you need to save as this file as a secondary file, because if you wouldn't do that, you can't import them to Revit. So let's create a save as from this Excel file to our desktop, and let me name it to IMP date. Okay, that's great. We can close this one, and this was the export process. Okay, that was the export process. Now let's import back those data here. As I said, you need to create a save as file and import from another file. Okay, the first step, you need to choose the a note here in import and export part in data, we have a node import Excel. The first input is file. To give a file input to this, you need two nodes. The first one is file path and the second one is file from path. Let me copy this one. Let me bring it here. Let me browse it and change the file and use IMP data. And as I said, we need another node, which is file from path. And we are going to use this to get a file input. And then we need to input it to here. The sheet name is as same as the export one. So we can use the this string here. We don't want to read them as strings. So it's gonna be a on default value. We don't want to see the Excel too. Okay, let's see the data here. As you see, we have some data, but sometimes you can get some null values, but we don't want them because it can be bad for our importing and for our setting parameters. The best way to get rid of these null values is clean node. You need to type clean here, and you have this grid node. Put the data in here, and also it needs to be false, because sometimes it doesn't work. Let me bring a boolean node here, and let me put it on false. You can see as a result we have the nulls again here, so put it on false and then connect this one to this. You can see we have a list, we have set of lists without any null value. Okay, that's great. And we want all of the department parameters here, storage, and all of them are in the second index. So we can use a item. We can use a node which is get item at index to get all of the department parameters here. Put it in here, and the index is 2. So create a code block and connect this to this. Now we have all of the. We need to see a list of department parameters. But you can see we just have it's not the thing that we want. What the node is doing right now is going to the first. It has been run in the first list, and it has been read the second index of this list. In this kind of situation, you need to work with levels. You just need to click on here, and you need to manipulate this level to get the exact thing you want. This is the thing that we want, because we want all of the second indexes in each list, not the second list of the first list. It's kind of easy, and it doesn't need any further explanation. So sometimes you need to use levels to get the right date. Okay, these are the department parameters, and we can use them to set them as parameter for our reps. Okay, we need to add a new node, which is set parameter by name. Okay, that's great. The elements are the room, so connect these elements to here. The parameter name is department. We have that here too, so we can connect this to this, and the values are this one. Okay, let's go to the this was the import process. Let me make them a little bit compact and cleaner. We don't want to see the previews here, and we can create a group for them, and let me put it on import date. Let's change the color of it. As you can see, we have the export process and import date. Let's go to the Revit, and let me select one of these rooms, and let's see that we have the data or not. As you can see, you have all of the department data automatically. according to your Excel file. It was a really easy example, but you can use it for many goals, for example, fire rating, for your walls, for anything. And it will enhance your processes and open lots of potential for new automations.
I hope you enjoyed this process, and I hope you will you would use that in your future processes. And don't forget to like this video and share it with your friends. This will help us a lot to create more videos like this. And you want to get access to our exercise files and premium tutorials, go to our Patreon page. The links are in the description. Don't miss out. I will see you on the next session.